provide. And the reason for that inscription is for you to take care of that breakable glasses. Because if you drop it, like you drop other items, the tendency for the gold glasses to break may be there. That is why the inscription is there. So if your wife offends you, always see that inscription on her. Breakable. And we will clear. And when you are able to see this inscription on her, you will not go further with something that you can better do. You should not be violently angry with her action or saying what will you do. The person goes back and wastes his pen. Instead of you say, okay, let's go to the hospital, or you start shouting on her while she has not prepared your food, I'm going to give you a therapy. This therapy has been given to many husbands and they have succeeded in their marriage. This therapy is called HRT therapy. Do not go to the market to buy it. You have it yourself. What is HRT? Hand rubbing therapy. Just go close to her. At that back and the well that is paying her, start rubbing it. Talk something to her, and mighty to her, she continue to rub. At the time you hear her, I beg me. Continue to rub, because I beg me in human language means I beg rub me more. And as you rub her, before you know it, you have finished and it's done. So these minor problems that can be handled by my spirit can go a long way to make it happen in the marriage a happy one. We have spoken at large the responsibility of the man, but we also have a responsibility. If you want your husband to dearly love you, yes, you have many things to do. The Bible shows that you have a role in marriage and your role is honorable and dignified. Christian husbands are told, come on. You should be and my spirit. The Bible says that the woman should speak to the husband. And if you do, then the marriage will be a happy, a loving and lasting one for that matter. Your recognition of his leadership will promote marital success and happiness. See how the Bible puts it at the book of Ephesians, chapter 5, verse 22 to 24. Ephesians 5, 22 to 24 says, let wives be in subjection to their husbands as to the Lord. Because a husband is the head of the wife, of his wife, just as the Christ is the head of the congregation, he is a savior of his brother. In fact, as the congregation is in subjection to the Christ, wives should also be to their husbands in every family. So that's your responsibility. To be in subjection to your husband. Although the scripture says it's a relative one, and being a relative one is to the happiness of both the man and the woman. When there is no headship, what results? Discord, confusion, and unhappiness. That is why the same Ephesians chapter 5 verse 33 has this instruction to give to you joy. Ephesians 5 verse 33. It's a familiar scripture, but let us read five verses. Nevertheless, Each one of you must love his wife as he does himself. On the other hand, the wife should have deep respect for her husband. Not a shallow one. She has deep respect. And when this respect is exhibited in the home, you see that there will be happiness. Do not compete with your husband. In no circumstance you will compete with your husband. He is the position. Of course, you can give suggestions. And this suggestion should be given with my temper, my spirit, a quiet one. And when your husband says that your suggestion is good, he will decide to carry it out. And when you see him carry it out, don't say, young one, okay? It's cultivated in the marriage. Both men now put themselves in the gap law. Today, anyone see you can see how handsome and beautiful both of you are. What has contributed to it is the clothing. It is in the same way that love in the marriage can enhance the beauty of your marriage. You have not been happy, or this or today is one of the happiest days of your life. You may have had happy days, but today is one of the happiest days in your life. So, is the woman coming back? She can also buy for her husband. You know the food your husband loves so much. Can you prepare that food so that when he comes home, he becomes happy? If you do your own part and the boss is good part, you see that your family will be united. Make it a habit to show kindness in little things. Sometimes you may see the finger of your husband has grown. Can you pick his hand, put it beside your armpit, and start cutting the fingernails as both of you are discussing? The man will be happy. And sometimes the man will do certain things that will gladden the heart of the wife. So these little things, as you practice them in your home, your family will be a success. And the home will be a happy of rest. Now, let's enter into the wedding procedures before the vows. Okay, please, after this question, you can answer, I do. I hear me, after the question, Udo Chigbu, in the presence of Jehovah God and these witnesses, take Joy Agadema Chigbu, as your wedded wife, to love and to cherish in accordance with the divine law as outlined in the Holy Scriptures for Christian husbands for as long as you both may live. Your answer?
Yes, I do.
Let us now to the bride. You, Joy Agadume Jogu, in the presence of Jehovah and these witnesses, take Larson Udo Chigbu to be your wedded husband, to love and to cherish, and deeply respect in accordance with the divine law as outlined in the Holy Scriptures for Christian wives As long as you don't meddle it, you answer?
Yes, I do.
Thank you so much. Now let's tell the married part. The groom.
I, last name, Udo Chigbu.
Thank you.
Joy, Agadema Chigbu.
To be my wedded wife.
To be my wedded wife.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
In accordance with the divine law.
In accordance with the divine law.
As set forth in the Holy Scriptures.
As set forth in the Holy Scriptures.
For Christian husband.
For Christian husband.
As long as we both shall live together on earth.
Shall live together on earth.
According to God's marital arrangement.
According to God's marital arrangement.
Now to the bride. I,
Chigbu Joy Ogadema.
Thank you,
Larson Udo Chigbu.
To be my wedded husband.
To be my wedded husband.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
And deeply respect.
And deeply respect.
In accordance with the divine law.
In accordance with the divine law.
As set forth in the Holy Scriptures.
As set forth in the Holy Scriptures.
For Christian wives.
For Christian wives.
For as long as we both. Shall live together. On earth. According to God's marital arrangement.
According to God's marital arrangement.
Please. You can now exchange rings. This ring or rings is an outward and visible sign signifying unto all the uniting of this man and this woman in the bonds of matrimony. Please come up and check your certificate. Come up to the last one. For as much as Larson Udo Chigbu and Joy Ogadema Ejogu have been covenanted before Jehovah and before these witnesses to accept each other in wedlock, I, as an ordained minister, am by the authority conferred upon me by the Holy Scriptures and the Federal Republic of Nigeria, they are now pronounced as husband and wife together. Now let us. Brother and Sister Larson Chigbu. Yeah. drama is so slow. Thank you. The audience of 217 persons says thank you to Brother A.Y.Zewa, who has successfully delivered the public the parish talk, Honorable Marriage in God's Sight. I think the principles, if applied by our principal host, Brother and Sister Larson Udo Chigbu, and all married couples, the global focus of marriage will be achieved, and everyone of us will be happy. The greatest thanks goes to Jehovah, who has made this day a wonderful one, and a family has started. There are Larson and Sister Joyce must be written in heaven as a family. Please listen to these few announcements. To the compound there and take photographs. Then, when we go to the reception, we have been told that those who have vehicles should park at the car park outside the everyday emporium so that it can be easy to get to the reception. So when you get there, you take instructions from the attendants who will be directing people to how they have to pass. Because it's also a business environment. So if you pass well, you also have an easy access to where they live. So these are the brief announcements we'll be having. Remember, the reception is, for those who don't know, at the Everyday Emporium by GRA. Please, so if you don't know the place, ask others who know so that you can also get that place safely. I would like to close this meeting by singing song 132. Now we are one.
Thank you. was waiting for so long for a miracle to come. Everyone told me to be strong, oh, oh, and don't shed a tear. Through the darkness and good times, I knew I'd make it through. And the world thought I had it all, but I was waiting for you.
Hello.
I beg you for the finish, what can I get to be?
speak for them. They said they like him. What was there? On a two feet open abortion. On a not even two feet together. On a new two feet. So me, I don't need two feet. They can use two feet to any other side. So please, the event is already taking shape. We are going to. So please, what we have next year is refreshments. But refreshments have been going on. So we are going to cut the cake. But before the cake will be cut, please, those young guys, those men of suit, move and carry this thing come here so that people there will see them cut the cake. Those men of suit, move and come carry the cake, come for here. Let me to snap picture one and do that. So I beg, go back, carry and come here. So while they are doing that, and I remember saying, I told them, I say, Larson, tell me, say, it could beat the world. You say you will give this man HIV. If you say I don't receive the message, the H there are happiness. The I, now, immeasurable joy. You know she's joy already. So he will give her, she will give her happiness and immeasurable joy. Joy where you don't fit measure with anything at all. What about the V? Nobody can ever tell on my name. Can you imagine that? When I go, as I reach home one with my wife, the taxi driver, in fact, the Abro went to load the car. He said, Ogoro, two chance, enter. I said, he said, wait a minute, this Ogoro, enter, come, come, enter, Ogoro, enter, front seat, you and your wife. Nah, my name is Ogoro. I didn't say the guy is abusing me. That's why I enter. Balance. When I reach that NNPC, I say, Oga, make I stop here. Now as I draw, open the door, one come out, the worker big man is in, the man come hold me. Say, what I know to pay? I say, but my income is going for no more than I say, make I enter with my wife. You don't serve me again. He said, who be you? I said, I need your corona. I need your corona. Which make I enter for corona? He said, my friend, I need to pay me my money. You know, not so corona. I don't know corona there for front. No, you be your corona. So let me guys, I come here and I face. I said.
My husband will look at me. Anyhow, where is it? Your work finished when they enter in the hall. My husband will look at me now.